Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the workshop. We're going to be taking a look at some more products from ArttyStation. I reviewed one of their workbench organizers not too long ago. Let's move the camera over. I still use it every single day, getting more and more use out of it all the time. Well, they've got some smaller modules, and I said I'd like to take a look at those. So they sent over five of them. If you don't have a giant workbench like I do, and you have a smaller bench that you need to work on and organize things, I had them sent over their paint racks in the 26 millimeter and 36 millimeter size that I'll be putting together. I had to have them send over their ArttyStation Solo, which is a much smaller version of the workstation to the left over there, with product holders, phone holders, small paint containers, brush and paint holders, upper tray for holding plans, and a larger area for some drawers. Had them send over the drawers for the ArttyStation Solo, so you have a little more storage in that station. And they sent over part of the Opera Station, the ArttyStation Opera line. And we're going to have more holders in there and some brush and paint holders. I wanted to show you some various things that they had that aren't as big as the giant units, that are more affordable for the beginning modeler and modelers that just want to get things organized on their bench so that they can grab easier. Now, always remember with the folks at ArttyStation, they give cash back if you put a review on their website or on your social media in public that everyone can see. They will give you money back. Also, the reason I really like ArttyStation, if you have anything missing, they include an entire sheet on how to request a part so that you don't have to worry. They guarantee 100% free reshipping service for any kind of damaged parts. And you won't see that with a lot of companies. They're going to want you to spend a lot of money to send these heavy wood items back. So I'm going to start taking the parts out for each one individually, build them up on camera, and we'll come back as we go. The two paint stands took a total of maybe 35 minutes to put together. Now, when you assemble these, and I'll demonstrate them with paints and the different sizes, and you know, at the end of the video, we'll have actual paints, but let's just look at the construction right now. When you assemble these, you can use super glue or epoxy. Wood glue, even though these are made of wood, it's such a smooth MDF, so well made, that the glue will not adhere to it. It's got a waterproof coating to it, a super smooth coating, and it's even hard to get a magic marker to work. Even a Sharpie marker, I marked each one as like a 26 millimeter container or a 36 millimeter container, and that's how they go. So when the drawers pull out now with your paint, they will tilt forward without spilling all your paints. Just like so. Each one will open up just like so and go back and forth on those ball bearings that we looked at. So I have also been using, if you own one, these are super handy if you do woodworking. I've been using my Makita pin nailer, and it uses super tiny nails that are like the thickness of pencil lead, even thinner. And that fires them in to the sides. You can't even see barely where they go in, and it holds this, these very nice and securely, so I don't have to wait for glue to dry, and they work perfectly. Now they do include a bunch of dowels in the containers with the ball bearings, and that's for all these holes at top. You can see where I put some dowels in, this one right here, and then all you have to do is stack your modules, push those dowels through the bottom side, and you can start building bigger paint racks that all stick together and don't slide around. So I'm going to demonstrate this with some paint, but we've got three more other modules to put together, and let's get to them. Thank you. The ArttyStation solo module that I showed you goes together super easy. We even have it holding its own plans. This one's got some really cool plan holders at the top. It's got some pieces of wood that have been designed to hold your instructions up and hold your manual open for you. I know sometimes you got to fight with a manual. Having that on the side of the bench with those three holders up there, the manual just slides in between the little tweezer look there and just sits right in there. We've got another slot here to hold single page manuals up. We got our paintbrush and knife holder right there off to the side. What I like to put up on stuff like this is stuff I don't want to roll off, like hobby knives, if I don't have them in their holder. We got sanding stick holders over here. We got paint jar holders all the way across the back and more storage in the far back. And we've got the circular holders and the square holders for the most common Tamiya glues. And we got a nice little rail there. So that goes together super easy. No problems at all with that. Shoves together. You can see the backstop on there. All nice construction. I use my pin nailer again. If you're curious about that pin nailer, this is not a review of the pin nailer. It is the tool number right there, XT-P01. I actually did a review of this, so you can look on the channel and see the review of how a pin nailer works and what they're good for, so which is definitely items like this. So we've got the solo station to go. We've got two more things to go, and I'm going to get to work on those. The drawer system for the Solo is all set to go. Now, the reason this is designed like this, you're like, well, big deal, it's just some drawers. The little Solo system we built, if you desire, you can see on the sides, it's got holes. This has got pegs. You just put them on top of each other and press them together. That's why I'll look at it at the end, but then you can have an entire module with drawers underneath it, holding your plans and organizing on a smaller bench. That's going to work out real nice. Each drawer just comes in and out as you need to get items, and you can see each drawer has items there. You can store it. You can move these around depending on the brand or size of paint bottle you have or tool you want to store, and everything works well. So I'm going to push those two together just on the sides like that. They just interlock, and then we're going to keep building. We've got one more to go from the Opera system, and I'll be back so we can look at them all together. And now, with very little work, we have Opera Module 4 built. Now, when they use these names, Opera, Solo, Pico, stuff like that, what it means is if you buy modules, you don't have to buy all the sets in one day. You could buy this set 1 month. You could buy the paint stands another month. You could buy the Pico set that I built a while ago, the little bit bigger one, another month. And you can slowly build your collection. And if they have the same name, if they're all from the Opera collection, or they're all from the Solo collection, then you will interlock them and enjoy them. So we can see the nice features of module number 4 in the Opera collection. We've got a massive amount of brush and knife holders so that we can have our painting. We've got this little removable roller. We've got these two wooden sticks here. What this is for holding and tearing off perfectly straight lines in wax paper, aluminum foil, stuff like that, paper, you know, just regular masking paper, stuff like that, that allows you to tear it off. We've got our jar holders, our glue bottle holders, etc. Those are all set right there, so this is a nice little module. Now we'll raise it up a little bit, and as you can see on the top here, they include dowels, so we can start joining things together. You can see on the sides of the modules, they've got dowel holes, always. The other parts of the Opera module, let's reach across the bench, are those paint holders. And those will go right on top. We'll push them down on those dowels. And there we go. Now we have interlocked systems that are all pushed together, that all work together. And now we've got our paint stands, we've got our brushes, we've got the larger paint bottles, everything all in one unit. So you can see it from top to bottom. Isn't that cool? We're getting a totally modular system that builds in just minutes, goes together super easy, and we can start working on things and having exactly what we need organized at our fingertips instead of hunting and fighting around to find stuff. It's all right there for us and easy to use. So I will get the other module out that we built, put them together for one final reveal so you can take a look at them. A truly revolutionary system by ArttyStation. I'm absolutely glad I found out about this brand, and they are so kind to send over items for review. There will be links down in the description for all five modules that we've seen today. The drawers, the upper solo module, the bottom opera module, and the two paint holders. You can see that everything fits in there nicely. We've got different types of inks and glues and airbrush paints in the lower racks. We've got the standard Tamiya square bottles of all different sizes. We got our CA glues in there. We got our plan holder on top. We can hold our files and our brushes and our pens and our markers. And of course, all the most popular brands of paint fit just fine. You can see in the smaller racks that testers paints fit beautifully. You can pull them out without everything falling down. The Tamiya paints and Model Masters all fit in. When you tilt them forward, you notice that not everything goes flying, and we will be able to store dozens upon dozens, and we can add on modules and 26 millimeter and 36 millimeter and all different sizes, and actually store all our brushes, even my giant wide fat finger friendly brushes all fit in there, my files. You can jam these things full of product and you'll get a nice thing. Now don't forget, if you have any issues with yours, you can just get a hold of them and they will send you the replacement parts that you need. Also, don't forget cash back. Get some money back. Do a review. Do what I do. Do a quick little review of it. Submit it to them and you'll get some of your money back for your review. So we thank ArttyStation for sending these over. Super easy assembly. If you have a pin nailer or a fine brad nailer, these will go together super quick. Otherwise, you just got to wait for epoxy or super glue to dry on them. And that's another way you can build them easily. Or like you saw when I built the Pico Station, which is hiding over there, I just used a very strong packaging tape and it held everything together as well. Wasn't as cute, but it doesn't matter because it works perfectly and I use it for every single build. So can't wait to fill this up with all my paints over in the painting area, get everything organized. Doesn't matter what size bench you have or what your budget is. You can slowly build up modules and decide what you want to go or what you need or what you don't need for your model set. So thanks for coming along at the workshop. We'll see you at the next review. Links in the description, like I said, to pick up these items I will have down there for you. See you at the next review.